Welcome to Paper Pen Biology. First of all, I am glad to have subscribers more than 500, and I am thankful to all of you for encouraging me till now. Despite of all odds, you guys are still with me this journey of learning. So cheers to you. Pandemic becomes unpredictable. Waves of mutated variants of COVID thrashed many of us. It is advised to develop vaccines with proper efficacy because of its changing frequency. Today's video is about vaccines and its type since its discovery. I use these two books as reference for making this video. So please go through these books for better understanding. So let's learn. Many previously common childhood diseases like diphtheria, measles, mumps, whooping cough, poliomyelitis, and tetanus are seldom seen, and it is testament of the effectiveness of vaccination. Vaccine is a popular term nowadays. It is clear that vaccine is a cost-effective weapon for disease prevention. The World Health Organization has stated that the ideal vaccine would have the following properties. First of all is affordable worldwide, heat stable, effective after single dose, applicable to a number of diseases, and administered by a mucosal route, suitable for administration early in life. At first, we need to know about immunity, antigen, and antibody, which are deeply associated with the process immunization. Immunity is ability of an organism to resist a particular infection or toxin by the action of specific antibodies or sensitized white blood cell. And that particular infection is caused by foreign particles, viruses, bacteria, or toxins, which is known as antigen. An antibody is a blood protein that is produced in response to counteract these specific antigens. This immunity I have discussed here is achieved by active or passive immunization. Active immunization is achieved by inoculation with pathogens that induce immunity but do not cause diseases. And passive immunization can be acquired by natural processes, as in transferred from mother to fetus or by previous infection by the organism. Here are some examples of each case. Before coming to vaccine, the active immunization, I must inform you a bit more about passive immunization. Edward Jenner and Louis Pasteur are recognized as the pioneers of vaccination, but similar recognition is due to Emil von Behring and Hidesaburo Kitasato for their contributions to passive immunity. In the past, before vaccines and antibiotics became available, passive immunization provided a major defense against various infectious diseases. Passive immunization does not activate immune system. It generates no memory response, and the protection provided is transient. These are the common agents used for passive immunization. Vaccine or an immunogen. The term has been derived from the Latin word vaccinus, meaning from cows. It can be defined as a non-toxic or non-virulent preparation of antigenic material that can be used to induce long-term humoral as well as cell-mediated immune response against pathogens. Vaccination is not 100% effective. A small percentage of recipients will respond poorly and therefore will not be adequately protected. But this is not a serious problem if the majority of the population is immune to an infectious agent. In this case, the chance of susceptible one is not likely to become infected. And this phenomenon is known as herd immunity. Anything from whole organisms to small subcellular fragment can be used as antigen in vaccines. Common vaccines currently in use consist of live but attenuated organisms, inactivated or killed bacterial cells or viral particles or protein or carbohydrate fragments as subunits of the target organism. This is the list of vaccine type we are going to learn today. Microorganisms can be attenuated so that they lose their ability to cause significant disease. but retain their capacity for transient growth within an inoculated host. The first vaccine used by Jenner is of this type. Vaccinia virus inoculation of humans confers immunity to smallpox but does not cause smallpox. Attenuation can often be achieved by growing a pathogenic bacterium or virus for prolonged periods under abnormal cultural conditions. These procedures select mutants that are better suited to growth in the abnormal cultural conditions and are therefore less capable of growth in the natural host. The advantages of live attenuated vaccine is due to their capacity for transient growth. This vaccine shows prolonged immunogenicity and eliminate the need for repeated boosters, that is repeated inoculation. And the disadvantage of this vaccine is there is the associated risk of reverting back to virulent form. However, these days, genetic engineering is also used to cause site-directed mutation, causing irreversible removal of virulence genes from attenuated organism, making them safe for use. These are the examples of live attenuated vaccine. The Sabin poliovirus, consisting of three attenuated strains of poliovirus, is administered orally to children. In intestines of it induces production of secretory immunoglobulin A, which serves as an important defense against naturally acquired poliovirus. It also induces immunoglobulin M and immunoglobulin G class of antibody. Inactivated or killed vaccines are produced by inactivation of pathogenic organisms by heat or chemical treatment so that organisms are unable to multiply in the host. Inactivation is carried out in such a way so that the structure of epitope is a part of an antigen molecule to which an antibody attaches itself. So the epitope on surface of antigens remain maintained. Hence, heat treatment is generally not satisfactory since it can cause protein degradation and thus loss of some epitopes. Thus, chemical inactivation using formaldehyde or other alkylating agent is more common. Inactivated vaccines are effective, but they are less immunogenic, so often require several boosters and normally do not adequately stimulate cell-mediated immunity or secretory IgA production. Here are examples of inactivated vaccines. We can draw a clear comparison between attenuated and inactivated vaccine. Generally requires single booster dose in attenuated vaccine, and in case of inactivated vaccine, it requires multiple boosters. Attenuated vaccine is less stable while the inactivated vaccine is more stable. Attenuated vaccine induces humoral and cell mediated immunity while the inactivated vaccine focuses only the humoral immunity. There is a problem using attenuated vaccine, which is that it may revert to a virulent form, while in case of inactivated vaccines, it cannot revert to a virulent form. Many of the risks with attenuated or killed whole organism vaccines can be avoided with vaccines that consist of specific purified macromolecules derived from pathogens. Three general forms of vaccines that are currently in use are inactivated exotoxins or toxoids, capsular polysaccharides, and recombinant protein antigen. Toxoid is a bacterial toxin that has been modified to be non-toxic but retains the capacity to stimulate the formation of antitoxin. The current vaccine for Streptococcus pneumoniae, which causes pneumococcal pneumonia, consists of 23 antigenically different capsular polysaccharides. The vaccine for Neisseria meningitidis, a common cause of bacterial meningitis, also consists of purified capsular polysaccharide. There are conjugate vaccines, basically polysaccharide protein conjugate is considerably more immunogenic than the polysaccharide alone. There are certain viral subunit glycoproteins such as an envelope protein from HIV-1 have been tested as vaccine with little success. In the case of recombinant antigen vaccine, the gene encoding Any immunogenic protein can be cloned and expressed in bacteria, yeast, or mammalian cell using recombinant technology. The first recombinant antigen vaccine approved for human use is the hepatitis B vaccine. The immune response generated by recombinant antigen vaccines is primarily humoral. DNA vaccines, also known as genetic vaccines, using the genetic material of the pathogen itself to immunize the individual. In this class of vaccine, fragments of the pathogen's genome encoding antigenic proteins that are injected directly into the muscle of the recipient, where they can integrate into the chromosomal DNA or exist as episomes. Of December 2020, there are over 200 vaccine candidates for COVID-19 being developed. Of these, 52 candidate vaccines are in human trials. Having lots of different vaccines in development increases the chances that there will be one or more successful vaccines that will be shown to be safe and efficacious for the intended prioritized populations. This is all about today's video. Please follow the guided COVID rules to keep you and your surroundings safe. Put a comment below for any suggestions or queries. We'll be back soon.